Charger Lab got a 96 watts USB-C GaN charger from HP. It has a foldable plug and supports an input voltage of 100 to 240 volts. It has a USB-C output port. It adopts a black shell made of a fire-retardant PC, and the surface is frosted to resist fingerprints. There is an HP logo in the center of the front. The word 96 is written on the lower right corner of the back, indicating the maximum output power of the charger. The specs info is printed at the bottom. Model is ADP96AWA. It can support an input of 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz 3 amps. It can support outputs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, and 20 volts 4.8 amps. The maximum output is 96 watts. It is UL certified and has level 6 energy efficiency certification. Here is the foldable plug. It only has one USB-C port. Its size is about 68.3 by 68.3 by 30.9 millimeters. It is slightly smaller than the Apple 96 watts charger. And the weight is about 217 grams. ChargerLab Powers EKM003C shows the USB-C port can support PD 3.0 and DCP charging protocols. And it has four fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, and 20 volts 4.8 amps. Next, let's take it apart to see its internal components and structure. Pry open the shell. The top and sides of the PCBA module are covered with an integrated aluminum alloy heat sink, with glue at the three corners. The bottom of the PCBA module is covered with a brass heat sink, and the corners are also glued. Remove the heat sink. And there is insulating tape on the inside of both pieces. The components on the front of the PCBA module are reinforced by potting compound, and Mylar sheets are used to isolate the capacitors from the output PCB. The potting compound on the back of the PCBA helps dissipate heat. Clean up the potting compound. The components on the front of the PCB are arranged compactly and orderly, and heat sinks are provided on the edge to help the bridge rectifier dissipate heat. On the back of the PCB are the master control chip, primary MOSFET, optocoupler, SMDY capacitor, synchronous rectifier controller, and synchronous rectifier. There is the time delay fuse. 5 amps 250 volts. The NTC thermistor is used to suppress the power-up surge current. Here is the safety X2 capacitor, 0.33 microfarad. The secondary common mode choke is wound with flat copper wire and has a green core. The bridge rectifier is from World and adopts GBU package. The operating temperature is -55 to 175 degrees Celsius, 15 amps 1000 volts. These two electrolytic capacitors are from Acon. 400 volts 39 microfarad. The third electrolytic capacitor is also from Acon. 400 volts 120 microfarad. The master control chip is from Southchip. It is a high-frequency quasi-resonant flyback controller with a built-in GaN driver that can be used to directly drive enhanced GaN FETs. The chip has built-in X-capacitor discharge and high-voltage startup, and has an adaptive switching frequency fallback function. The primary MOSFET is from Navitas and adopts 6x8 mm QFN package. This is a highly integrated GaN power chip. 170 milliohms 700 volts. The optocoupler is from Everlight for output voltage feedback. The SMDY capacitor is from TRX. The synchronous rectifier controller is from Southchip. It is an adaptive turn-on detection and fast turn-off synchronous rectifier controller, compatible with multiple modes, and supports multiple working modes. The synchronous rectifier is from AOS and adopts the FN5x6 package. 100 volts 5.1 milliohm. The three solid capacitors for output filtering come from Polycap. 25 volts 1000 microfarad. The protocol chip is from Ingenic. It integrates multiple protocols for fast charging of USB output ports. The V-bus MOSFET for output is from Phitek and adopts PRPAK3x3 package. 30 volts 3.9 milliohm. Here is the component list of the HP 96 watts USB-C GaN charger for your convenience. Its shell is black with a matte design, equipped with a foldable plug and a USB-C port. After taking it apart, we found it adopts QR flyback topology. The main components it uses are from well-known brands. The gaps between components are reinforced with potting compound, and the PCBA module is covered with heat sinks. The workmanship is solid. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.